But let's quickly shift focus in terms of Eicher Motors. Vinod Agarwal, who's the MD and CEO, who's joining us on the phone lines. Welcome to the show, Vinod. To start off with, firstly, overall, if we see in terms of where the VECV sales are concerned, on the domestic front from November, from a number of almost 4,900 units, we've seen a jump to 6,888, and we've managed to stay above the 6,000 number from December onwards. Do you expect this trend to continue?
You know, right now there is a lot of optimism in the market, and the industry is growing very well, and it is going to touch, it is likely to touch the new peak in 2017-18. After 2011-12. So 2011-12 was the earlier peak, and this year it is likely that it will touch the new peak in 17-18. And with this optimism and with the growth that is happening, we are also growing in line with the industry. So as a result of that, you see these figures of close to 7,000 sales last month and also in January.
Right. So overall, 25% is the kind of jump that we've seen. Domestic market also, as you mentioned, has been pretty much steady. But if we see from Jan to February, in the domestic business, from 6,010 units, it's dropped down to 5,876. What's the reason for that?
No, this is very difficult to, you know, see it on month to month. But if you look at overall, overall we are doing very well, and it is in line with the industry growth. And then you will see the you know, if the industry grows like this, then you will see the similar growth numbers coming from us.
Okay.
So it's very difficult to, you know, measure it month from month to month.
So Vinod, if you could just help me understand between light medium duty vehicles, bus, as well as the heavy duty vehicles, from these three segments, going ahead, which are expected to be the growth drivers?
Growth drivers are going to happen in all the segments.
Okay.
Like, for example, if you look at the growth drivers, the biggest growth driver is the optimization that has happened in the entire logistics sector. Because of that, there is a lot of demand that has come in the medium-duty trucks, which is 12 to 15 ton, and also the higher tonnage trucks. And then you also see a lot of traction in e-commerce. E-commerce is also leading to a lot of growth because you need more and more, as you know, which are efficient trucks for transportation, because there is a lot of, you can say, the if you have to move the goods to take care of the requirements of companies like Amazon or Flipkart, then the time is very important. You have to make the deliveries on time. So you need absolutely rival and better technology trucks. So that is another area that is leading to the growth in the sector. Then there are overloading restrictions in various states now. Earlier, overloading was rampant in some of the states. Now, you don't see overloading, because of which, again, the customers are migrating to the high tonnage trucks. So all these are leading to the, you can say, the growth, and the growth is going to happen in all the segments, in the medium duty as well as in the heavy duty.
Vinod, very interestingly, in one of the last interactions that we had, you had guided for a 7,000 number in terms of the month of February. Again, slightly lower than the 7,000 sales figure that the management had guided for. Any reason why there has been a slight miss coming in there?
We are very close to 7,000, 6,889 to be precise in February, including Volvo trucks, because we also sell Volvo trucks in heavy-duty segment.
Okay. And very lastly, what's the expectation? How are we expected to end FY18? Because overall, VECV is expected to be one of the biggest beneficiaries of the recent trends that we are seeing in the regulatory space. The vehicle scrappage policy also for phasing out vehicles which are older than 15 years, and the restriction on overloading of vehicles, which you mentioned, are also some of the key positive triggers. With all of this said and done, what is FY18 expected to end with, and how is the first half of FY19 expected to look like?
FY18, as I mentioned, you will see new peak. You know, you already have, like, if you take the heavy duty segment, we have a growth close to 20% already first 11 months, and then if you take light and medium duty trucks, you have growth close to 25%. And then, of course, if you take sub 5 ton or sub 3.5 ton, again, there is a growth of almost around 25-30%. So you see good growth in all the segments. And as a result of that, it will touch new peak in FY18. And going forward, FY19 also, there is a lot of optimism based on, as you mentioned, end-of-life policy, which is expected soon. And then, of course, lot of focus on the infra projects. For example, you see a lot of action in road construction, in rail metros, or in construction or development of new cities. Like, for example, Amaravati is being, the new capital for Andhra Pradesh. So that is being totally constructed new. So it needs a lot of trucks to do this construction, to support the construction activity. Then there are various irrigation projects which are underway. So based on all these infrastructure projects, then these regulations, end-of-life policy, overloading restrictions, e-commerce, and already you are seeing positive traction in FMCG sector or consumer durables, and we are also expecting positive sentiments in the rural economy. So all these are very, very positive for FY19. And as a result of that, we are expecting that at least for next 2 years, FY19 and as well as FY20, when the BS6 will get implemented from 1/4/2020, you will see a better movement in the CV industry. So CV industry is likely to continue to grow even in the next 2 years.
Right. And very lastly, Vinod, in terms of where capacity is concerned, you are almost running at near full capacity. With the kind of strong demand for the CV space due to the rising infrastructure spends that you are seeing, as well as delivery of e-commerce shipments as well by leaders like Flipkart as well as Amazon, do you think there would be a need to increase capacity?
Yeah, of course. We will take that call in the next few months if we have to need to increase the capacity.
Okay, but by how much do you think you would have to increase in case you have to, and what do you think would be the spends looking like in FY19?
No, that of course we have still not finalized the details. In next 3 months we should be able to finalize that.
Right, all right, Vinod. Pleasure speaking to you, and thank you for sharing all the details as well. So yes, it's basically the infrastructure activity as well as the boom that we are seeing in the e-commerce space. That's what is driving the CV space up move currently as well. And as Mr. Vinod Agarwal, who's the MD and CEO at VCV Aisha Motors, indicated that there is a possibility that they could have to increase capacity going ahead because currently they are running at near full time capacity. But in the next 2 to 3 months is when they will take a call as to what the quantum of increase that we will see in terms of capacity is concerned, and secondly, what are the kind of spends that they will be looking at as well. In the last 5 sessions, 2.5 to 3% is the up move that we've seen, but in the last 1 year, around 20% is the kind of upside that we've seen on an Aisha Motors. In fact, earlier today as well, we connected with Bharat Madan, who's the group